several days ago, Hurricane Irma wreaked havoc in the lives of thousands and thousands of people in South Florida. Almost 5 days later, the citizens of this area, the citizens of Miami-Dade County, the citizens of Florida, for the most part, are without power. Right here in this neighborhood where we are standing right now, we came back yesterday. Many of the homeowners, the renters, they told us this was the first time since Irma that anyone from any organization came to find out about them, find out what they need, to find out what they are going through. We are standing today, many organizations, to ask this question. Where is FEMA? Can you say it with me?
Where is FEMA?
We are standing today as a coalition of many organizations to ask, where is the Red Cross?
Where is the Red Cross?
Almost a week after Irma, both FEMA and the Red Cross are missing in action. You hear me, guys? They are missing in action. So people who live in this neighborhood, in these buildings, they have no water, no ice, no power, no food. I'm not going to talk any longer. I'm going to let them speak for themselves because they are the ones who have been living in this sweltering heat without any support from our local government, without any support from FEMA, without any support from the Red Cross. We're going to start with Captain Haiti, who's a business owner, followed by Joseph Jean-Pierre D. We're going to ask them to be very brief in their remarks. Now, demandez nous pour ne parler seulement en minute. Because it's hot. We're going to call you one after the other. Solamente un minuto, por favor. Your minute to Napali. Va commencer avec Captain Haiti. Dis pas de problème. We'll talk about your experience in Irma.
Hi, my name is Captain Haiti. I'm fighting for economic justice on behalf of Haitian businesses and Haitian patrons. Here in Middle Haiti, mostly, we have businesses that are being pushed out of their places of business already prior to Irma. Now that the residents can even get to them, or they can even have resources to support these businesses, what I'm asking you to do is to get some resources to these businesses without power, because they were fighting to pay rent, they were fighting to pay electricity and their water bill, etc., and now it's even worse for them. So come to Little Haiti and support Haitian businesses. Haitian businesses, come to Little Haiti and support the same population that's been supporting you. Thank you. Next,
we're going to call Mr. Joseph Zafferdi. He's going to tell you about what he's been going through. And then we're going to bring a powerful voice who's going to tell you about our demands, why we are here.
Moi, c'est Joseph Jean-Ferdi et ma vie dans la communauté haïtienne là. Et nous comptons justement pour que nous fassions parler avec la presse. Et ça, nous ne comprenons pas, c'est que. Et nous comprenons que c'est toute ma amie qui est affectée par le cyclone Irma.
Ok, my name is Joseph Jean-Ferdi. I'm so happy to see all of you here finally. What I don't understand, I understand that we all have been impacted by Hurricane Irma.
Mais nous ne comprenons pas qui ça que la communauté haïtienne méprisée comme ça parce que.
But we don't understand why this community is left out. We don't understand it.
Because depuis ça fait une semaine déjà, nous n'avons pas aucun gouvernement passé où nous. Nous n'avons pas la Croix Rouge. Nous gagnons depuis 5 à 6 jours depuis que nous dormons, pas d'électricité, chaleur, nous n'avons pas de manger, nous n'avons pas de foyer.
It's been almost a week. Our families have been suffering. We haven't seen the Red Cross. We haven't seen FEMA. We don't have electricity. We have not been able to cook. We don't have water for our children.
nous vraiment pas qu'à supporter situation ça encore.
We cannot stand it anymore. We cannot stand it anymore.
Donc s'il vous plaît, font Jean pour nous parce que nous besoin assistance.
We need some help. We need some help and we need it now.
Thank you.
All right. Merci beaucoup. Thank you. All right. Where is FEMA?
My name is Umi Fela. I'm the co-director for the Dream Defenders.
And we're here today together representing a statewide coalition of community-based organizations that work on racial justice, economic justice, climate justice. And we came together in the days before the storm as Hurricane Irma was barreling through the Caribbean because we were concerned about our community. Because this is not our first storm. This is not our first storm. We saw what happened after Hurricane Andrew, what happened after Hurricane Katrina, what happened after Hurricane Harvey, and there are some things that we know to be true. Poor communities and wealth communities have different experiences after a storm. Communities of color, African American communities and immigrant communities have different experiences than white communities. And we also know that government relief often doesn't make it to low-income communities of color. And the workers that come in to help in the recovery effort and in the rebuilding effort are often exploited, subject to wage theft, hazardous working conditions. That also we know to be true. So this is not our first storm, so we set up the Hurricane Irma Community Recovery Fund as a way to get resources immediately into poor black and brown communities across the state. We came together in the days after the storm to deliver meals into communities where the families are hungry, where they desperately need food, where people need medical assistance. And this week we served over 7,000 meals in Miami-Dade alone and many more across the state. This is not our first storm. But together we need to protect our most vulnerable communities and ensure an equitable recovery.
Miami-Dade's poor communities have been underwater for years, for decades. You may not see the water at our knees on the news, but believe me, this is a fact. So it should be no surprise in the most unequal city in the country that corporations and developers have a seat at the recovery table, but the people who need it the most do not. The governor is on a tour right now getting pats on the back. But let me tell you, this is an unnatural disaster. We didn't miss Hurricane Irma. The eye of the storm has been running up and down this state from the Keys to the Panhandle for decades. And we demand a seat at the table for our recovery. We cannot wait any longer, and so community groups have come together to demand that the resources that are being given out, the billions that are being given right now to corporations, to the Red Cross, to FEMA, to developers who want to take Little Haiti and neighborhoods around this state, are directed to the community who most needs them, because we know what the need is, and we're willing to go into the communities that they refuse to see, the communities that they continuously organize and ignore and have been ignoring before Hurricane Irma and will continue to ignore. We demand a right to stay in the places where we live. We deserve a right to our pay for the times that we could not go to work. We deserve a right to return into our homes, and we deserve a right to dictate where the recovery goes and how our communities look after the recovery. We know that we know our communities better than anybody else. And a developer, an investor, a gentrifier does not come from on high with messages from the bank of God. We are the people who know our communities best, and we deserve a say and a right to say in what our communities look like.
Soy Andrea Mercado, soy la directora ejecutiva de la nueva mayoría de la Florida.
y estoy aquí representando una coalición expansiva de grupos comunitarios que trabajan para la justicia racial, la justicia económica y la justicia climática. Y estamos aquí porque nosotros en los días antes del huracán Irma, cuando vimos cómo estaba destrozando a comunidades en el Caribe, sabía que teníamos que crear un fondo y una manera de ayudar a las comunidades más pobres, las comunidades de color y las comunidades inmigrantes. Y sabemos esto porque esto no es la primera tormenta que pasa por aquí. Y sabemos que en todas las tormentas, sea el huracán Andrew, sea el huracán Katrina, el huracán Harvey, sabemos que en estas tormentas no todas las comunidades tienen la misma experiencia. Las comunidades pobres tienen una experiencia bien diferente a las comunidades ricas. Las comunidades afroamericanas, latinas, inmigrantes tienen una experiencia bien diferente que las comunidades anglo. Y también sabemos que muchas veces los recursos que vienen después de la tormenta no llegan a las comunidades pobres. Y también los trabajadores que empiezan a trabajar en la limpieza, en la construcción, son explotados. Vemos mucho robo de salario y vemos también muchas condiciones peligrosas de trabajo. Estamos aquí para decir que nuestras comunidades pobres, nuestras comunidades de color están sufriendo. Estamos viendo casas donde familias no han comido en días. Estamos viendo casas donde personas necesitan hielo, atención médica, personas que necesitan poner su insulina en hielo, situaciones muy graves de personas que no pueden salir de sus departamentos y necesitamos recursos inmediatos, no solo aquí en Miami-Dade, pero en todo el estado. Y no sabemos dónde están los recursos que necesitamos. Estamos aquí exigiendo que vengan, que pongan la luz lo más antes posible, que distribuyen comida, supplies y otras cosas, y que también que tenemos el derecho de permanecer en nuestros hogares. Si no vamos a poder pagar la renta porque no estamos trabajando esta semana, los empleadores nos deben pagar por esos días de trabajo, debemos poder quedarnos en esas casas, y también los empleadores no nos pueden despedir por no llegar al trabajo porque no hay transporte público en muchos lugares en este momento. También estamos exigiendo que escuchen nuestras voces, que no es solamente las grandes corporaciones y las personas con más recursos que deben estar dirigiendo la reconstrucción. Las comunidades más afectadas, las comunidades pobres, las comunidades de color, tienen que tener espacio para decir lo que nosotros necesitamos. Y vamos a estar aquí apoyando a las comunidades hasta que regresen las luces.
Que no te habiten a Zanio, que nunca sufrí, no te puedo seguir plasmando tu tabla, ¿es que no tapó? No te puedo decir que ça m'a besoin, no te puedo decir que ça m'a besoin manger, no te puedo decir que tu puesto está a valer, no te puedo decir a bota de la tua decisión, ¿no te tapó? Where is the red cross?
Where is the red cross?
Where is FEMA?
Where is FEMA?
Do you need them here, right?
Yeah.
When do you need them?
Now.
All right. We're going to bring up some other folks who have been experiencing, going through some hard times since Irma. We're going to call forward Jean-Napier, and he will be followed by James St. James, and then also followed by Mildred de la Mesa. Jean-Napier first.
Hola, buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Mildred de la Mesa y estoy aquí para decirle que desde el día del huracán no tenemos electricidad. Ya la comida que hemos tenido se nos ha agotado. Tenemos niños pequeños, no tenemos agua, no tenemos con qué hacer los alimentos. Estamos pasando 20 necesidades. Tengo un sobrino que tiene 3 meses. El agua de prepararle su leche también se ha agotado. Y aquí no ha venido nadie absolutamente a preguntarnos nada hasta que han llegado ustedes. Necesitamos un poco de ayuda, por favor, porque como pueden ver, yo tengo un niño pequeño, más mi sobrino que está durmiendo en casa. Y bueno, nada, solo necesitamos ayuda de comida, agua, que pongan la electricidad, etcétera, etcétera. Toda la ayuda es poca la que nos puedan brindar a mí y a todos los vecinos y a toda la comunidad que ha podido sufrir. Muchas gracias.
Sí. Turn the lights on!
All right.
Thank you, Mr. Napier.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is John L. Napier. I live at 1250 Northwest 2nd Street, Martin Luther King Boulevard. 1250 Northwest 2nd Street, Martin Luther King Boulevard. every storm comes through, we had no light, no cold water. It's been hot, just stay in the house. And me, I can't go through that number with my body. I really like, I need lights on now. I need some AC. I need a fan. I need a lot now. Oh, you know, so that's what I've been going through with after the storm came through.
You need help.
I need help.
All right. We had you.
Thunder light on.
All right, Ben Dean. I'm going to talk to you about his experiences in Irma.
All right, brother. Hello, St. James with Miami Dream Defenders, Black Lives Matter Alliance of Broward. And everyone on the news right now is acting like we just dodged a bullet. Right now, Rick Scott and his cronies are patting themselves on the back, but after the hurricane, when we ventured back out into our neighborhoods, what we saw was devastation. No power in our communities, left in utter darkness at night, food deserts are made even more scarce as supermarkets are wiped out, broken water mains and boiling water notices, power lines on the street bursting into flames, and my mother who came to this country for a better life, had to resort back to the survival skills she learned while growing up in Haiti. 5 days after we supposedly dodged the bullet, the recovery has still not made it to the people who need it the most. My mother and thousands more just like her. See, I'm one of the few that's blessed to live on a block that has power, so right now my one-bedroom apartment, I have four people staying in there. My friends and I have been waking up every single day since the hurricane to do the work that the state should be doing. My sister-in-law is Valencia Garner. She has rallied several organizations together to feed our communities. We've been having cookouts. We've been giving out free food and water. We've been going door to door, talking to the people. But most importantly, we've been listening to what they need and doing our best to help. Another brother has been going from house to house, Francois Alexander, to clean up trees and clean up debris left from the storm. We have New Florida Majority, Dream Defenders, Make the Homeless Smile, Miami Worker Center, Catalyst Miami, FUM IUCN, and so many other community-based organizations that are doing the work that the state should be doing right now. And to add insult to injury, we got our Governor Rick Scott that's being congratulated. Yeah, Voldemort. He's being congratulated. While the recovery still has not made it to the people who need it the most, to my mom and a house full of children, to the elderly people dying in their nursing homes because of heat strokes, to the poorest neighborhoods who still have no power, no food, no clean drinking water. So I want to know, now the people want to know, where's FEMA?
Where's FEMA?
Where's the Red Cross?
Where's the Red Cross?
And where's the billions of dollars that you have raised in our name?
Yes. Thunder lights now. All right. Now we're going to hear from Miss Brown. And I'd like Miss Gigi to also come. Miss Gigi and Miss Brown.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. My name is Shanice Bryant. I'm with the Miami Worker Center. Yes, you've heard a lot of stories around gentrification, that no light, no water, no food. Where is FEMA? Where is the Red Cross? But the Worker Center has one thing we left out, the housing issue that Miami-Dade County and the state of Florida has been facing for many, many years. We've been in this state of emergency around housing for a very long time. And when I talk about a state of emergency around housing, I mean around the slumlords that are taking money from off the back of this community and not fixing the places that these people in the community are living in. I have behind me two residents of the community of Liberty City that live in one of the biggest slumlord of Liberty City. A executive own property in Liberty City, and these folks right here have either lived there or currently living in there right now. When that their roots are coming in during the storm, they're going to tell you their story. But a resident has property on Miami Beach that looks good. The people there are living well. They don't have to worry about the storm. But these folks, these black and brown people that live in our community that are paying their rent to this slumlord, actually, the building has been taken over by the city. Tell me that the city come and check on these folks. They know the building has been taken over by them with a receivership. And the city has not decided to even come to the residents of these folks to see if they were okay. Did they have light? Did their roof come in? I'm going to bring before me Miss Sonia. Miss Brown. She's going to tell you her story. She's a current resident of one of A's back in his property.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Brown. I stay on 6040 building. Due to the disaster, this was a disaster before the hurricane came. Like, ceiling leaking, like, it's just crazy. I complain, nothing has got done due to the hurricane. As me and my nephew walking in the door, like, the whole ceiling came down on us in the living room. Like, I still had to sleep in there with roaches coming out the ceiling and had to wait days. Like, we've been without lights, hot, like, nothing's been done. Like, they just get around now to help us out and do things for us. All we ask for is help. I have a 2-bedroom. I have a sister and a cousin that didn't have nowhere to go due to the hurricane, and I opened my doors to them. And due to that, it's like, we still living, like, on the outside of the street. So all we ask y'all to do is give us some help. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. Auntie, I used to stay in Haiti back in the 1231 building, but thank God I got out of there. But we still need help because when I was staying there, I had the rat sensation, I had the roaches sensation, I had all of that. I had a ceiling where they had to tear the ceiling down because it was a leak in there. But thank God I got out of there, and I've been on the section. And for the city, I've been on the section aid list ever since 2008. And I have seen where people that was on the section list after me, they have a place to stay, but I still don't. So where's the help?
Yes.
Where's the help?
Where is the help? Okay, we have someone who always stands up. Even before he became an elected official, he always stood up for every struggle, every fight that this community has put on. It is my honor to say hello to Jose Senator, Senator Jose Javier Rodriguez. He's always been there. He's always for us. I know he's not going to speak, but I wanted to make sure to introduce him because before he was an elected official, he was a concerned citizen, and now he's a senator. He is a concerned senator. Thank you, Senator.
Thank you.
All right. Come on. Always there. And every elected official who have showed up, thank you so much. There is someone really we hold dear because he was there before he was elected, and he continues to be present. Thank you so much. All right. We're going to continue. We're going to call Jack Lieberman and Jovia Lafortune for 1 quick minute. Jack Lieberman is a board member from FANM, and also he represents 350 South Florida. Jovia Lafortune is the chair of the Haitian American Grassroots Coalition, and they understand they have 1 minute each.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Jean-Robert Lafortune, and I chair the Haitian American Grassroots. I am a Sikh person, and I can share with you that since last week with Irma, I did not get any insulin in order to help me sustain with my life.
Wow.
And it is with sadness that I witness Miami-Dade County officials, the Broward County officials, in their efforts to mobilize the community, but however, our community was not even mentioned. I believe this is now that we must do what it takes in order to sensibilize the governor of Florida, the president of the United States, Mr. Trump, and also the leaders of Miami Dade and our county, so that we can be more fair in providing coverage to the community. Because we too, with 1 million people in Miami Dade and Broward, we deserve attention. Not yesterday, but today. We need them to take a stock, to take advantage, to listen to all people. Because of that, we know that the FPL do not care much with our communities. If they care, I would have liked in my home in order to assist myself. I'm somebody with a congestive heart failure. So these things are not mean. I accuse Florida Governor Scott for not paying attention to our pleas and our plight. I accuse Mr. Trump for not being at the forefront in order to show that community of colors, minorities, they too deserve a fair share in the federal assistance. I also accuse the Red Cross, the FEMA people, for not being on top of the other things. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So you heard that. He said he has congestive heart failure and a no help. Jack Lieberman, 1 minute. And I was going to have members who will be reading our demand. But before we do that, all the phone members who've been working, I'd like them to come and stand here. They've been feeding people, selling going canvassing all over this place to bring out the plight of our citizens. We'd like all of them to come on this side to be recognized.
Yes, I represent 350.org, which is the largest environmental justice group in the world. We have chapters in over 30 countries. And I'm here basically to make a statement that Harvey and Irma are a wake-up call. It's the 3 o'clock in the morning call that was talked about during the campaign. It's not about nuclear bombs. It's about a catastrophe in nature that's like an atomic bomb. If you watch the news about the people on the Caribbean islands, they were hit with like an atomic bomb, like a hydrogen bomb. And it's way beyond midnight, and action needs to be taken now. We cannot talk about these disasters without talking about climate change and the drastic changes that we need in our economy in order to stop this catastrophe from going on further. We need to cut fossil fuels. We need to tax the fossil fuel companies who are making buco dollars off of the misery that we are suffering. We cannot go on with business as usual. We need to institute policies like mass transit that are available for poor people and working people. The county commission right now, it wants to cut mass transit and put more automobiles on the road. That's exactly the opposite of what needs to happen. Politicians need to wake up and take action. And we need to realize that the poor communities and people of color and working people didn't create this crisis. It's the big corporations that are responsible, and they have to pay. And we need to tax them and provide services to communities like this one and other communities around the state and in Texas that are suffering as a result of these disastrous policies.
All right. Thank you, Jack Lieberman from 350 South Florida, and also some board member. Guys, I couldn't end this. We're not ending now, but we're going to listen to the demand. End this conference without recognizing these some members. They've been going door to door in this community to listen to people's problems, door to door. They've been bringing water, food. They've been doing it in the hot sun. Sometimes, you know, we without any food themselves. So I really wanted to recognize them because they've been, day after day, they hit the ground and they haven't stopped. Thank you so very much, guys. All SWAM members and volunteers. Thank you. Now, guys. You've been hearing about the members of this community. You've been hearing about the health of our organizations. Now, we want to hear about our demands, the coalition's demands. What are we asking them to do? We know that we've been doing most of the jobs that they should be doing, but officially, we want to stand up and tell them these are our demands. So please come forward. I don't have all the names, but please. Members of the collective, please come forward to read the demands.
Welcome, everyone. This is our community, and we made a list of demands, and these are our demands. The community asks for the right for food, water, and safe housing. Many low-income families could not afford to evacuate and purchase supplies for the hurricane. The power outage has left many houses and households and crisis for their basic needs. People need food, water, ice, electricity, immediately, regardless of their immigration status. People need a relief on their income, on their rent, October 1st, because most of them have experienced most of their needs to take care of their families. This is one of the men.
All right.
Communities demand the right to return. Memorandum on eviction. Every Floridian deserves the right to return to safe and affordable housing in their home neighborhood. With missed paychecks and damages to buildings, Irma is creating the perfect storm for climate gentrification in low-income communities of color. The governor and local officials should institute an immediate moratorium on unscrupulous rent increases and evictions for tenants in small businesses to give our community time to return and rebuild. Miami-Dade County should create a rent relief fund to help families replenish what rent funds they were forced to use to prepare for the storm, so that they are not evicted from their inability to pay their rent. Thank you.
Right. We demand a right to stay. This is not a time to target immigrant communities. Many immigrant families in South Florida, including Haitians, are fearful of asking for help despite their extreme needs, putting their lives in danger. In addition, we call for an extension of TPS for all Haitian refugees. Thank you. We demand the right to provide for our families. Pay time off. No one should lose their job because they had to evacuate, care for elders and children, or secure their homes during the storm and its aftermath. Whether they are salaried or not, all workers should be paid for time missed because of Irma. Thousands of people are doing the backbreaking, dangerous work of clearing roads, caring for the sick, and restoring our power. We honor their work and sacrifices, and their employees should too.
Right.
Community has come together and we demand a seat at the table. As we learned from our friends in Texas, Louisiana, when low-income communities of color don't have a seat at the table as post-disaster decisions are being made, our concerns are ignored and left out of the long-term plan for rebuilding and recovery. As government officials design programs and allocate funding to rebuilding and infrastructure projects, space must be created to listen to and act on the needs of those of us who disproportionately bear the brunt of the fallout from Hurricane Irma because our housing, infrastructure and economic stability were already in extreme state of disrepair and neglect even before the storm. We ask them to act now.
Now.
Act now. All right. Act now.
So today we want to let you guys know that we call for light,
right.
food, water, equity and relief.
Officials, all of you, you heard us.
We want it now.
Hit our call. You heard us. Hit our call.